I'm Shwan Basu, and I'm going to tell you about some progress on quantum optimization. As an outline for the talk, I'm going to talk about the QAOA, apply it to the SK model, apply it to MaxCut on large-girth regular graphs, which will turn out to be connected to the SK model, and then we'll generalize the results to higher spins. The QAOA stands for the quantum approximate optimization algorithm. It is a general-purpose quantum algorithm for approximating solutions to combinatorial optimization problems. And here's how it works. We start with the uniform superposition S of all bit strings. Then we apply e to the minus I gamma 1 C and e to the minus I beta 1 B. C is the cost function of your problem, and B is the sum of the poly X's. And then you do that again with gamma 2 and beta 2, all the way to gamma P and beta P. So there are two P parameters, and the goal is to pick these parameters in a way that maximizes the probability that you measure a string near the optimal. So you can think of this as a hybrid algorithm where you classically update the gammas and the betas. So the first problem I'm going to talk about is the Sherrington-Kirkpatrick model, or the SK model. So its cost function on a bit string is given by that equation. So each bit takes plus or minus one. And you can see for any pair of bits ij, there's a coupling jij with mean zero and variance one. So it is known that for this problem, the ground state energy density is given by the Parisi value, which is about 0.76. A few classical algorithms of this problem include spectral relaxation, which gets to 2 over pi, about 0.63. And there's also a message passing algorithm that gets epsilon close to the optimal. And there's the assumption that the problem does not have the overlap gap property, which is a topological property of the solution space. It is believed that this assumption is true, but it hasn't been proven yet. So in 2019, those authors applied the QAOA to the SK model, and they gave an iteration with time 16 to the p and memory 4 to the p that outputs what here I'm calling VP, which is the performance of the QAOA on the SK model. When I put a bar, that means I'm optimizing over the gammas and the betas. So at p equals 1, the QAOA gets to 0.303. At p equals 2, it gets to 0.407. So on the right, you can see the plot all the way to p equals 12. Most notably, at p equals 11, the QAOA surpasses the 2 over pi, which is the SDP. SDP gets to. Now I'm going to tell you about a problem that seems to be unrelated, but like I mentioned, it will turn out to be related to the SK model. So MaxCut is a graph problem where you want to partition the vertices into two sets, and a way that maximizes how many edges have endpoints in different sets. So you can think of each vertex as being a bit, and its cost function on a bit string Z is given by that equation. So when two, again, the bits take plus or minus one. So when two vertices are in different sets, their product is going to be minus one, and the term contributes to the cost function. So we will restrict our attention to graphs that are large girth, meaning they don't have small cycles, and d plus 1 regular, meaning that every vertex has d plus 1 neighbors. So for these graphs, it's known that the best cut fraction, that is the best cut you can get divided by the total number of edges, is given by half plus something of order 1 over root d. So we'll call this numerator g. It's known that as d goes to infinity, this g goes to the Parisi value. Classical algorithms for this problem, again, include spectral relaxation, which again gets to 2 over pi. And there's also a message passing algorithm that gets to epsilon close to the optimal, but again, it assumes that the problem does not have the overlap gap property. So you can see a lot of similarities with the SK model. Now apply the QAOA to this problem. We're going to refer to its performance by nu p. So again, it's this numerator in the cut fraction. It is already known in the d to infinity limit, with appropriate parameters, that p equals 1, the QAOA gets 2.303, p equals 2 gets 2.407. So again, you can see there's a lot of similarities with the SK model. One of our main contributions was to provide a computational procedure that takes in p, d, the gammas and the betas, and outputs this new p, the performance of the QAOA. It takes time p, 16 to the p, and memory 4 to the p. In the d to infinity limit, this procedure becomes much simpler, and it takes time p squared 4 to the p and p squared in memory. So the key insight that allowed us to give this iteration is as follows. So given the assumption that the graphs don't have small cycles, and we actually need for the girth to be at least 2p plus 1, Then locally, everything looks like a tree. So the QAOA is a local algorithm, and on the eyes of the QAOA, when you analyze, when you compute the expected value of some edge, in the eyes of QAOA, it looks like you have two trees glued to their roots, just as in the picture. And given the symmetry of the problem, every leaf contributes exactly the same to its parent. And every parent contributes exactly the same to parents of parents. So you can recursively collapse this tree, and it yields the iteration given in the paper. So I'll very briefly show the iteration so you get a sense of what it looks like. So we need a few definitions. So we have bit strings of size 2 plus 1, and they will be indexed 1 all the way to p, 0 minus p all the way to minus 1. There's this vector capital gamma, which depends on the little gammas. And there's this function f that takes bit strings and outputs some trigonometric function of the betas. So here's what the iteration looks like. We'll define p plus 1 matrices. So the first matrix, G superscript 0, its entry jk is given by the sum over all bit strings of f of a, aj ak. Now we're going to use g0 to compute g1. So you can see the second equation gives actually a recursion on the g. So you can see g superscript m depends on g superscript m minus 1 inside the exponential. So with g0, you compute g1 and then g2 all the way to gp. Once you have gp, then you can use the rho 0 to compute new p, as in the last equation. And this is proven to be correct in the paper. So we numerically implemented this, the weight of p equals 17, optimizing for the angles. And you can see, again, p equals 11, we surpass the 2 over pi. This implies that the QAOA at p equals 11 and greater is the best assumption-free algorithm for this problem. Now, if you remember the plot that I showed before for the performance of the QAOA on the SK model, the plots are very similar. So here's what I'm going to do. I will overlay both plots, and here's what happens. You can see they're exactly the same plot. So always new p bar seems to be vp bar. So that begs the question, is that true for all p? Is that true for all parameters? And we answer that question positively. So we show that for every p, every gamma, and every beta, vp equals new p. That is, the performance of the QAOA on the SK model matches its performance on MaxCut for large-girth regular graphs. And this is surprising for a few reasons. For one, the SK model is a complete graph, whereas on MaxCut, we're talking about sparse graphs. Also, the SK model is actually an ensemble of graphs that we are averaging over, but somehow you can replace it by a single instance of a graph in the MaxCut case. So given the numerics, we make the optimistic conjecture that as you take p to infinity, new p bar approaches the Parisi value. Or in other words, that iteration that I showed previously is a way to compute the Parisi value. Now we're going to generalize the results to q spins. So MaxCut is actually a particular case of the MaxQ XOR problem, which has the cost function given by the first equation. So instead of having the product of two z's, now we have the product of q z's. And now there is this coupling, the j, that can be plus or minus 1. So MaxCut is the case when q equals 2 and all the j's are minus 1. So you can see again, the other equation shows the iteration that I already showed before. And I'm going to show you how to tweak this iteration to calculate the performance now for MaxQ XOR on large-girth regular hypergraphs. And here's what it looks like. All you have to do is to raise, in the second equation, the matrix elements to q minus 1. In the last equation, you raise to q instead of 2. And there are some constants that you need to change. But you can see that you can generalize very simply the iteration from MaxCut to the iteration from MaxQXOR. And you can see that the complexity, time complexity, and memory complexity are exactly the same and do not depend on q. So we implemented this iteration for different q. So the blue curve is there already the curve that I showed before for MaxCut. And then we plot from q equals 2 to q equals 6. And in this plot, everything is rescaled by the generalized Parisi values. For every q, there's a different Parisi value. And here, everything is rescaled by the Parisi value. So the goal is to get to the red line at 1. So here's a very interesting question. You can also generalize the SK model And instead of having a product of two z's, you have a product of q z's. So this is a generalized Q-spin model. Now, it's already known that there's a connection between the optimum of the Q-spin model and max VXOR, which is given as follows. So again, the cut fraction in the max VXOR case is 1/2 plus something of order 1 over root d. And this numerator, again, depends on the generalized Parisi value. Meanwhile, the generalized Parisi value is the ground state energy density of the Q-spin model. So this begs the question, is the equivalence of the QAOA dynamics that we showed between MaxCut and the SK model, is it also true when Q is greater than or equals to 3? So this is a question that is very interesting and that we've been thinking about. And to conclude, we gave a new technique to analyze the QAOA at high depth. We showed that the P equals 11 in greater QAOA is the best assumption-free algorithm for MaxCut on large-girth regular graphs. Turns out that the performance on that problem is the same as the performance on the SK model. And as a consequence, our iteration is actually in a quadratic improvement in time and an exponential improvement in time, an exponential improvement in memory when compared to the previous iteration that computed the performance of the QAOA on the SK model. And then we also show that we can easily generalize iteration to compute the performance of the QAOA on the MaxQXOR problem for large girth regular hypergraphs. And with that, I'd like to thank my co-authors, and thank you very much for listening.